If you're really rooted in the struggle and you know how much time you spent in them county buildings and the welfare offices and on the curb and being harassed by the police, your heart will always be there regardless. That's how it is with J-Rock.
First mixtape, Watt's Finest, Niggas and Garden Projects. He was leaning over the sign. 90059, that's where he from. He can't go too long without telling you where he from.
He's always there physically, mentally, spiritually, because that's who he is.
Imagine rock up in that field where options ain't so audible. Problem steady falling, the effects is like some dominoes. Issues chronological, gotta get that money fast.
What's crazy is when I first heard J-Rock, he was in the booth recording, but the lights was out, everything was dark, so I couldn't see who was in the booth. Started off small, selling all nicks and dimes, rock head. So I just hear this voice, sound like a grizzly bear or something.
He had this really aggressive voice and you really could feel him.
I like to describe him as a humble beast.
And when I first heard him, it was just like, damn, this dude is raw.
That voice that he got, it's just like an instrument on its own. You're gonna take to that off top before you even hear what he's talking about.
What you working on? What you working on right here, my nigga?
I'm working on some murder right now.
Rock's scary. Because he's so serious.
I mean, J-Rock was always a humble dude. You know, you get this image of J-Rock, like he's just this aggressive super, this, that, that. Oh, he a blood. If you tear his voice and look at him, yeah, he looks scary as a motherfucker.
You rolling?
Back again, bitch.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
I'm already looking like Marvin Gaye and this nigga put the gang all in my face.
Y'all here chilling regular day, you know what I'm saying? In the hood like it ain't nothing, you know what I'm saying? Y'all out here. Got my boy K-Dot right there. He right there thinking, you know what I'm saying? Well, J-Rock's life back then was a typical project story. It's filled with drugs, alcohol, gang banging, fights.
552.
Born and raised, project shit, that's all I know.
But then you mix that up with, you know, you got the candy house, the freezy house. You break the fire hydrant in the summer, everybody playing. It was a cool combination of good and bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, the first sessions were in Carson. Top built the studio on the back of his house. And J-Rock got locked in there for weeks at a time.
Me and my boy Dave Free, we put a mixtape out. The whole time, Dave was like, we gotta get this to Top. I'm like, damn, who's Top? He's like, Top Dog.
I saw Top at Watts Day. I was like, yo. You Top? He was like, yeah. I'm Dave, and I do a lot of shit. So he gave me a laptop to work on, took that motherfucker apart 300 pieces, and then returned it back to him while playing Kendrick demo tape.
I remember Top sitting on the side of the boys, like, go in the booth. Let me see if this really you rapping. He put me in the booth, and I freestyled for like 2 hours before he said, okay, this really you. And that was the beginning of my test.
Look at that nigga, man.
I'm so far ahead of my time. I got people 5 years from now pressing rewind.
y'all. I hate rappers. Where did you artists at? If it ain't a good picture you draw, don't bring it to the architect.
I met J-Rock probably the second day of being in the studio at Carson. Street poetry. You know, he was telling his tales of a youth growing up inside the niggas and gardens.
It ain't hard to tell that I live in hell. Sin City, Rock City, gotta get your mail. I sleep when I die, that's real. It's only two ways out, living life in the dirt or life in the cell.
We both share these similar stories about, you know, just trying to come up and make it out of these communities. This is what I want to be around.
As you may know, I grew up in a record shop, family-owned record shop, Magic Disc Music. I remember seeing J-Rock, Watts Finest mixtape, and like the free giveaway CDs. As soon as I noticed it, it seemed like I met him probably like a month or two later. Through Soundwave, of course, he brought me over there. Yeah, I pulled up to the studio. It's him and Kendrick in there, or K-Dot.
My nigga asshole.
Kind of felt like I was a part of the team instantly. For some, you know, the vibe was instant.
All right! Carson, California.
Try to get some B-roll, a little B-roll.
I first got into TDE through my cousin, who was Top Dog. Top was engineering when I first started coming around. Like, he was actually on the boards mixing. Everybody was just doing everything early.
Honestly, I got into TDE through Ali. I really wasn't trying to rap, though. And I remember, well, as we pulling up to the house, Ali like, your hood get along with bounty hunters? And I'm like, yeah, we cool, man.
That's it right there. Yeah. Yeah, and still making music while you're
here. My role in the early days of TDE was just figuring it out. So when I got there, I'm like, yo, this is different, like this structure here, you know? Like I never had a father figure per se, like Top ran that whole household. So I'm watching him maneuver and where he moved. I'm like, yo, like this is something I wasn't used to.
J-Rock was there that night. J-Rock, Absol, and Punch. I walk in the studio, it's dark as fuck, like super dark. I never recorded in dark spaces before. I remember Punch saying, you rap, and I'm like, yeah. I maybe rapped about 3 songs in my whole life. I was the fakest motherfucker in the room. You know what I mean? But I made it happen. It worked.
Rock like hell no.
Early on, the West Coast, it wasn't necessarily popping in the limelight.
Right here on 112th and Central, man. This is where we at, man. This is my street right here. You know,
I tell them best place in the world to live. In the ghetto, watch California.
Mainstream radio, television, they really didn't give 2 fucks about what TDE was doing.
I'm so getting more. Back then, it was important to have a major label co-sign you or stand by you, you know, or invest money into you.
Man, you know, that's the thing when you're a kid. You 16 years old, all you give a fuck about is getting signed.
There is some good news and some goodwill coming out of the projects. Mark Thompson, here with more. Mark?
You don't care about nothing else. What label, huh? They fucking with us? We signing.
Meet J-Rock. He might just be the next big thing.
When J-Rock signed Warner, I mean, we was all ecstatic.
His name is J-Rock. His debut album doesn't hit the streets till February, but he's already creating a huge buzz.
Yeah, that shit was a moment to see one of us get inside the building. Yeah, we was on it.
I can't really say it was a game plan back then because we didn't know what the hell we was doing back then. We was just trying to do whatever it took to get people to notice us.
It inspired all of us to keep pushing because, yo, this man's from the projects, this man comes from nothing, and he has a major record deal. You know, kind of put the battery in everybody's back, like, yo, we're really doing this, and let's not take it for granted.
Compton been doing their thing, Long Beach been doing their thing, and nigga Watts coming back in a real way, man. So it's a wonderful thing. Like I said, man, we on the map, we here, man. We ain't gonna stop.
We record songs every day, 4, 5, 6 songs a day, locked in, sleeping on the couch, sleeping on the floor. I ain't going home. This is a lifetime opportunity. I'm talking, we kids, bro. We have nothing.
Once we got the deal with Warner, we thought we made it. It's like, all right, we got the deal. That's it, we ain't gotta do nothing else. Well, that's the total opposite.
Ever since 13, I've been waiting for...
Good shit.
So we reached a point to where we needed to get out of that system. So we went there, had a meeting, and, you know, did what we had to do and got him off the label.
You where you were, man. Just a young nigga trying to make it, man. Uh-huh.
I've been in the game ever since Dinosaur Boo Boo. You smell what I'm saying?
They should be doing this for you. Woo woo woo. The label should be woo woo woo.
You gotta go out there and sell yourself too, though. I done seen the hottest niggas come and go in the industry over all the years I've been in this shit. You know what I mean? So, like I said, you want that longevity too. So, as long as you keep doing you, you know what I mean? You're gonna be all gravity.